you are with Breakfast. Thank you so much for your company. We're going to talk about risk this morning. Now, most of you will already be taking risks seriously. Thank you. But if you're not, if you think this is BC gone mad and nanny state and over the top and it's an act of defiance to behaviours if nothing's changed, please listen to this. We do now have a four-tier alert system introduced to help manage the risk of COVID-19 and as an effective and efficient way of explaining where we stand, basically. It's designed to act in a similar way to other national emergencies. There are four levels, and currently New Zealand sits at level two. But what does level two mean, really? What does all this stuff on the board in front of me mean? And how do we mitigate risk at level two? We're really delighted to bring in here University of Auckland microbiologist Dr. Siouxsie Wiles. Morena, Susie, on the tally, who's doing such fine and tireless work, for which, Susie, I want to say again, we are so grateful. Thank you, Susie. You rock. How are you?
Morena, John. I'm OK. You get to see my home office now.
Yeah, good. Well, you're phasing in and out a little bit, but we can hear you loud and clear, and that's what's important.
That's good.
And I'll tell you what we'll do. I'm going to bring over the top. Greg, our producer, has taken that brilliant graphic that you and Toby Morris made. Gosh, Toby's clever.
Well,
the two
amazing,
of you are clever.
He?
Yeah, he's and in combination, you're formidable. This is for the spin-off, but I know it's gone global. Now, this explains... So this is basically how social isolation works, right? We start with one person, he or she infects, on it goes. But if the one person worked from home and another person didn't go to a barbecue and another didn't fly domestic and another didn't stay at home, then we see the spread. Can you explain all of this to us, Susie?
Yeah. So I guess the first thing to say is that what we are seeing now is a reflection of what happened 1 to 2 weeks ago, right? So we have to, because of the incubation period of this virus, we are essentially 1 to 2 weeks, you know, what happens now will be reflected in what we see in 1 to 2 weeks' time. So the really important thing to understand about this virus is that for every person that gets it, they will probably, if they don't take the right precautions, they could infect 2 to 3 other people. And then each one of those, if they don't take the correct precautions, will infect 2 to 3 other people. And so you can see how within 2 weeks, this ends up with an enormous number of people, which is what our little graphic shows. So what we're trying to explain is that if you do things now, we can massively stop, you know, these chains of transmission for every person that's infecting. If you only infect one other person and they only infect one other person, then that dramatically impacts on where we're going to be in 2 weeks' time.
Because this is about compounding and exponential growth,
yeah,
right?
And so because we are running 2 weeks behind, I guess, one of the really important things to say is that if you entered into the country in the last 2 weeks, you came in before the restrictions were put in around self-isolation, we need you to self-isolate now. Because what we are seeing now is the fact that 2 weeks ago, there was, you know, a growing number of countries that had COVID-19, all the New Zealanders came home, and some of those brought the virus with them. And some of those have not been self-isolated because that was not the advice at the time. Well, it was the advice, but it wasn't, you know, it wasn't a mandatory thing. And so now what we're seeing is, you know, what we have to expect is that that will have spread from those people if they were infected. But we can all do something about this. And that's, I think, one of the things that's really important about the alert levels is showing us what we can do to take responsibility for helping too.
Okay, so let's talk about alert level two, which is where we are at now. What can we all meaningfully do? And Susie, can you be as explicit as possible about this? And I'm going to rephrase the question. What should we all meaningfully do?
Right, because that actually is sort of one of the problems with this, with the language that's used, is that it's asking us to do the right thing. It's saying, hey, I'm going to treat you like a responsible adult and you need to do the right thing. And so it uses the word should. And when people see the word should, they think that means they have a choice. Actually, I'm here to say where you see the word should, it says must, right? You must do these things. So if you are over the age of 70, we would say over the age of 60 for Māori and Pacifica, you need to stay home. You need to limit your contact with other people. No brunches, no coffees, no big gatherings, no gatherings with anybody else, no people coming to your home that aren't from your household. I know that you all feel fit and well and that you love your, you know, going out and socializing. You need to stay home now. If you have an underlying health issue, diabetes, you know, heart issues, respiratory issues, you need to stay home now. Again, you may feel well and good, stay home now. What are the other things on the list? Oh, for the rest of us, it's all about keeping our distance from everyone else.
Yeah.
That's 1 to 2 meters. This is really hard. It's disrupting everything we do. But we have to understand that every one of us that does this, if we are carrying the virus and we don't know it, it will stop that, you know, us giving it to somebody else.
Siouxsie, I'm, you know, this is, just makes sense, you know, and unlike you, I was abysmal at science at school and really didn't get it, but I understand this, and I'm a little bit surprised to see some people, and even some of our colleagues in this business saying, I will not be told, this is nanny state, I have the right to live my life. Those kind of considerations, I don't want to sound like a fascist here, but those kind of considerations have to be set aside for a greater good, don't they?
They really do. I mean, this is it's within all of us to help. So the government can do their thing, and I know behind the scenes all sorts of things are going on. But every one of us can make a choice today that will affect what happens in 2 weeks' time. And that, I guess my plea to everybody is make the right choice. And I know this is really hard. I know there's lots of things that are really confusing. But those of us who can work from home, we must work from home. Everything that we can do to break those chains of transmission will help us in 1 to 2 weeks' time. And honestly, our doctors are pleading with us, right? I mean, we're seeing that in other countries, you know, if you don't take these measures, I mean, gosh, you know, doctors are having to decide who lives and dies overseas. We know that our capacity is not as great as many other countries. So the actions we take today will influence that. So make the right decision.
Gosh, that's a good strong point and well made. Siouxsie, once again, I know I say this every time we talk, but thank you for for the damn you give and the care you're taking and the many, many, many interviews you are doing to just drill those simple messages into us. And if you think Susie's fantastic, then encourage people to listen to her and do as she says. Thanks, Siouxsie. You take care of yourself, and we're really grateful.
And you.
Dr. Siouxsie Wiles from the University of Auckland.
Oh, we are lucky to have Siouxsie in this country, aren't we?
Yeah,
we are. That was a clear, strong message from her, and every doctor and every scientist is saying exactly the same thing.
And we're going to do something really brutal later. We're going to bring Dr. Sean Hendy in, who does numbers and modelling and projections. And he's going to tell us what might happen if we don't listen to Siouxsie and we don't behave accordingly. And that is going to be quite a confronting interview. If you have any doubt about the efficacy and importance of doing these things, stay tuned for Sean Hendy later.
Yeah. What you have to understand is that the world has changed. And it's changed so quickly. Whoa. But as you say, the things we used to take for granted, we cannot take for granted anymore.
And we've actually got to live like we're all going to get it, aren't we? And so take those precautions. And for people like me, I've got my mum with lung cancer, you know, you've got to think of that one person that you want to save of this.
Actually, we all need to think of your mum. Because your mum, I know this is a tough thing to say, but your mum can't get coronavirus.
No, exactly. Yeah, and there's hundreds and thousands of people like mum.
A high rate of diabetes because of overcrowding in our houses and because of poor insulation in our houses. We have really high rates of bronchiectasis and other respiratory illnesses. We have to protect people. And we can do that by behaving appropriately.
Absolutely.